You can come into the lobby.
Where's the red hot chili peppers going to be?
He needs a steak.
Where's the red hot chili peppers going to be? What?
No, please don't.
Hi, Gary.
Marty. Happy birthday.
How are you doing?
36. It was fun.
Did you get smoked? Mm-hmm. You want a bagel or are you
ready? Hi.
Want a bagel?
Not right now. Thanks.
Are you ready?
Can she? So quiet.
You want me to take it back?
This has got that stuff in there.
Oh, okay.
By the talents of Los Gavilanes.
Los Gavilanes.
And as you see, there's 8 members in this group. And they put on their outfits for you.
Thank you very much.
All right, now these guys are going to be performing at various places at the Maharaja USA Festival this week. No, Saturday and Sunday, June 24th and 25th. And there's a lot of information about the group we're going to give you. And we guys, if you could stick around for a little bit longer, we'll need a few more, you know, Maharaja tunes as the show progresses, okay?
So did they vote you in with that big guitar, or did you choose to play that?
All right, so we wanted to kick off the birthday program. First of all, happy 36th to you.
Thank you very much.
And as you can see, you have a spread of different kinds of foods and drinks.
Yes, from this is amazing.
Hi guys, happy birthday, Brian. If it gets too crowded in there, they can come into the newsroom if they like. Tongues.
Be with you, Brian.
And don't let him change your clothes.
Do you need some help? No, not that I know, but we'll try.
Get fucking eat.
Get your fucking eat.
I'll tell you what.
Well,
I'm glad I married a Mexican girl.
Those girls. Well, good for you. Those girls. I mean, that early in the morning with the shot of tequila and the mariachi.
Pretty good, man. Making you happy?
Oh, yeah.
Where is she? That was the rest of my life.
You know what? I could surpass getting laid today if I could just watch you lay her.
Was it there?
Yeah, I was here.
That's what he's trying to do. So anyway, they live 4 minutes away.
Put the camera down.
It's not.
Jesus, your hair is almost as pretty as mine. Never said it.
Hey, I should tell you, I'd be laughing at these, but there's this guy. Painting something in my mouth.
I know. He's beginning the makeup.
I understand. Never said it. Back to my place. I've got the biggest collection of unreturned videos this side of Mississippi.
Well, that ain't me.
Number six.
Jim is best if you know.
With Jim the Top Nine Guy.
That keeps me.
Never failed
out of work. Ryan has just had the happy, smiling Bozo face drawn onto his face.
I don't want to mess up his makeup there.
Go ahead, Jim.
Number five. Oh, well, number five is unavailable. Seems that Brian has misplaced it. Number four. I could have been Bozo, damn it. Well, now you are, man. Your dreams come true.
Yes, it is.
The chicks are going to dig you. Number three. Oh, come on, Linda. Mark will never find out.
Oh.
Or nothing else works. Resort to dig
it. Yeah, she says that a lot.
Yeah.
Number two, I'd like to do to you what the KLOS management did to Chuck Motion on.
Oh.
Yeah, I like that
one. Jimmy comes in his finger. All right, Jim.
And the number one, Brian Phelps, think I'm learning. Why, yes, I am Dolph Lundgren.
Oh, man, you're the best.
Jimmy, you never fail to entertain us, buddy.
Hey, yeah. Rosemary?
Apparently, a jackknife semi is blocking the three right lanes, and you're going to find it slow from Wilmington there on the 60 east of Nogales, so with Pallet in the two middle lanes. Orange County, we got a major problem. We have a sick alert fire.
I love listener Jim.
Around 17th Street. Apparently, a car and a camper trailer fell over on its side. They pulled out right at the car, came here to land, but the camper trailer is still laying there in the two right lanes. The only lane open is the left lane. Backed up to Tustin Ranch, or the northbound side of the 5 southbound side. Backed up to the Garden Grove front. For the Jim Lord, I'm Ed McKay with Air Traffic on 95.5 KLOS.
Oh, it's this our tape?
Huh?
It's our tape?
Yeah, well, yeah. Can you go from the car?
No, that's fine. Yeah, it's good.
Hey, boy! Those are secrets.
Secret Mexican.
Oh. There's nothing, you know, if I keep drinking the tequila, there's nothing uglier than a drunk clown.
One minute, one minute.
He's got 1 minute, he's got 1 minute.
1 minute.
How are you doing, Brian?
Fine, Rosemary.
You get that wig out, and the costume.
Oh.
Bozo the Clown. And the music you hear is from that Rosemary Best. You do this because I just screwed the name up.
This is my attribute.
Ah!
I'm sorry.
Excuse me? Zeke, how? Sorry? Sorry? Oh, see, now she's talking another language.
You know, you people do probably a lot better if you changed your name.
Go ahead, Rosemary.
They're going to be performing at Mariachi USA Festival on Saturday and Sunday, June 24th and 25th at the Hollywood Bowl. This is an exceptional event. You must go check it out. Phone number is 310-451-5044.
All right. So there it is. Do check it out. Guys, you do sound super. Thanks again for coming in.
Thank you.
Okay, now as the makeup progresses on Brian, he is again being transformed into Bozo the Clown.
How am I looking?
You look great.
All right, Kevin, who is the Bozo, the Bozo that I never was, is making me up, but I can't see anything. Am I off good?
You'll see it.
Okay.
You'll see it.
All right.
As a matter of fact, we can go ahead and say this now. For those of you that are at the house, and you'd like to take a look at Brian, but you can't, of course, drive down. Later on this morning, and you will all have a chance to see the transformed Brian into Bozo the Clown live on Channel 5 here in Los Angeles, California.
No!
For those of you in the other cities, we're going to have some professional photographs made. They will be put on the internet, and you will have a chance to go online with the internet and see a photograph of Brian as Bozo the Clown.
No!
Brian, as you also know, today is not only your birthday, it is not only Cinco de Mayo, it is also right around our 10th anniversary together.
It sure is.
April 15th of last month was 10 years that you and I have been doing this radio program together. And to fully appreciate 10 years of working together, you've got to not only go back to 10 years that has our history.
Right.
You've got to go back to something even before that.
Well, you don't, really.
You do.
You don't gotta.
We're talking, of course, about what Brian did before we got together. He was with a comedy group that would tour various colleges and nightclubs and perform their comedy skits. And let's see, I'm going back, I guess, 11, maybe 12 years. Charlotte Volkman.
Yeah, Charlotte's she's like my sister. I was closer to Charlotte than I was my own sister.
Charlotte, how you doing?
Char. How you doing? How's your nifty?
Thank you.
I want you to sing along now, because I'm at home.
You remember that? Yes.
Come on.
Hello, honey.
It's our song, eh?
I know it is.
Not in front of so many people.
Now, Charlotte, you and Brian, you worked together with the stand-up comedy group for a while, but you also had a strong relationship with Brian. Didn't you work together at a restaurant or something?
Oh, yeah. We were waiters in Waitron units together at a Bennigan's out in the Chicago area.
In Niles.
In Niles, Illinois. And Brian wasn't really, he was a good waiter, but he knew it wasn't what he wanted to be for his life. So he'd let the customers get to him every once in a while. And, Brian, you probably recall this story. It's one of my favorite stories about the time this customer came in and, you know, Brian went up to the table and was like, hi, how you folks doing, you know? And the guy didn't even look up at Brian. And he was kind of at wit's end. He was having a bad day or something anyway. And the guy just didn't look at him. And he goes, two Bloody Marys and some fried cheese. And Brian just lost it right there. And he yells at the guy. He goes, say hi! Demanding that he acknowledge his humanity. The guy was so like, hello?
That's right. Hi.
And then he goes over to the machine to try to punch in all the, you know, the orders. And couldn't find a button or something like that.
Really shocking.
He slammed it down on the register, and all the, like, the fried cheese and Monte Cristo buttons. He said he knew it was time to take a leave of absence because they flew off, like, in slow motion.
I broke the computer. I hit it.
Yeah. And he said he was down on his hands and knees trying to put all the buttons right in the desk.
It's a bad day. I reckon so we all have those, don't we?
Yeah, I guess so.
Say hi!
Well, they didn't even look at me.
I understand. I fully understand, man. I do understand where you were coming from with that.
Charlotte, it's so great to hear your voice.
Brian, I gotta talk. We got lots of things to talk about.
Are you married?
No. No. Might as well be, though.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, there's a little tiny voice in the background. Huh? An 8-month-old boy.
Sure!
Oh. Well, let's hear it.
We're together. Remember when we went to Joseph last Christmas?
Yeah.
And the guy you met? Well, they were all together now.
I liked him.
Yeah, it's Todd and baby Lucas. Say hi.
Happy birthday, Brian.
Thank you.
Here's my baby. Brian, he's adorable. I'll send you a picture now.
What's his name?
Lucas.
Well, Brian, Charlotte has to get to work. She held a little longer so she could drive on in, but you guys should talk a little later today, okay, Charlotte?
Yeah, Brian, I'll get back in touch with you, okay?
All right.
Have a great day.
Thanks
for talking to us, Charlotte.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, now there's also one other name.
Amazing. That's
great. Charlotte was very special to you, so we knew one of the
Very, very special. But again, it wasn't for whatever reason, it never was a thing. It was a friendship and it was a family. She was like a sister. She was a sister to me.
But it was good hearing from her. Plus, she's got her a loved one and a child.
And for all you people from Chicago who know Harry Volkman, that's Charlotte's dad. Harry Volkman is the weatherman, the main man weatherman, like Dallas Raines and all that.
Cool. There's also another name that neither one of us have really talked to in a while. When we finally did get together in Birmingham, the simple beginnings of our Christmas show was nothing more than a couple of people dropping by the studio in I-95 in Birmingham, and the very first guest, in fact, with our very first Christmas show we ever had, he was the only guest we had, only one we could get in the room, but he was nice enough to come down. He brought his entire entourage. Please welcome Country Boy Eddie.
Wow. Hey, Country Boy?
Hey, Brian, how you doing?
Doing fine. You remember us?
Yeah, Lord, I reckon I do. Rock 95, I-95.
You know, you should...
We had a lot of fun down on the Christmas show, didn't we?
We did. In fact, you should know that our Christmas show, since our very first one with you as our first and only guest that day, has become the best show of the year for us. We packed the house with incredible stars and singers, and everybody has a great time. It all started with you.
My goodness, I'm really honored. Hey, you guys are really tearing them up out in California.
Well, for those of you that are listening, Country Boy Eddie, for years, has done a television show that starts up at 5 o'clock in the morning on WBRC-TV, and it's a very, it's a farmer's report type of program. They have live music, they give the weather, and he's been, how many years have you been doing this, Country Boy
Eddie? We've been doing it now 38 years.
My God.
38 years.
How's your entourage?
What?
Oh, your entourage.
Oh, everybody's doing great. Happy Al doing great. He's 89 now, and he's wilder than ever.
Happy Al. I remember Happy Al.
Does he still...
Happy.
Does he still have that Cadillac with the big horns on the front?
He's got the big horns. We do a lot of shows with it right here in Alabama.
Uh-huh.
And we pack him in. He always has the silver-mounted guns, the silver dollars, and everything. Yeah, and I have my mule out there.
Do you now?
Yeah, the old... Yeah.
And are we lucky enough that you might have that guitar close by?
Yeah, I got it, man. I want to say happy birthday to you, Brian.
All right.
What here has just gone on? Stand by, ladies and gentlemen. It's the birthday program for Brian's 36th. We're back after this.
Well, once again, I'm calling. Bozo is the best in the world. And here you stand.
Boy,
in the... The Bozo fit, man. You're ready to go.
I got one thing.
Yeah. Gary, you ready? All right, let's move inside. Come on.
Hi, Joe. How you doing? We're gonna have a ride.
It's not Brutal Tuesday today. Are you enjoying your breakfast?
Bozo the Clown.
Bye.
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 Everybody, Bozo Brian is leaving the area.
Oh.
We have the Bozo Pinata that maybe the kids might want to break.
Oh, kids, Joe. What's your name, son?
Darnell.
It's Joe Darnell. Okay, right, let's have a rip-roaring time. And this is a pinata because, you know, it's Cinco de Mayo. You know what that is?
That's it.
That's correct. And we're going to make, you know, in Mexico, they have piñatas. And so we brought you a piñata and ate it nice.
Oh, God.
Now, we'll hold up this piñata, and Darnell, you get to bust it open. And I bet there's going to be a lot of prizes and stuff, right?
Right.
All right, there, Darnell. Just go ahead and start whacking.
Whoa, step back.
Easy, Darnell. Almost got both those dogs. Oh, good one. Hit it hard.
No!
Oh, no! Oh, stand back.
Watch
it,
Chris.
Darnell, give it.
All right. Good work. All right.
It's just starting to break.
All right.
Both of them just got
That's what he used to do. He had like a little headlight.
You need to do it now, Jim, do it. Yes.
Can we make noise in here?
Yeah, but when I cue you, I want you to go.
Yeah, I want to be in here.
He has since that day been voted America's favorite.
Oh, God,
He has trained over 203 bozos. Please welcome Mr. Larry Harmon.
Hi, Larry.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
Oh, I'm doing good there, bozo.
Well, I understand today's your birthday.
It's my birthday, and when you retired, I went to the audition to replace you. There was an all-out search, and that's what this is all about.
10 years together. I remember that. I was talking to WG yesterday.
In a very strange way.
And I said, it's so strange
that
who missed getting somebody very special, I'm going to be with tomorrow morning. So WGN said to wish you a very, very happy birthday.
Oh, thanks, Larry. How are you?
Well, I have something special for you.
Okay.
Something very special. There's only, starting back, because next year, 1996, will be my 50th anniversary with Bozo.
Right.
Congratulations.
Y'all, I grew up with him. Bozo started in Chicago because of this man, and now it's become this institution nationwide.
Do you know anything you can stay around 50 years for, marriage or anything?
Absolutely. Congratulations.
It's a long time, right? Well, I have my original costume, nose, and everything else at the Smithsonian Institute.
Oh, my God.
Can I have that? It's right next to Irving Berlin's piano.
That is such an honor. How great.
I have never, in 50 years, ever given one of my original noses I started with 50 years ago to anybody, and I'd never autographed one, ever, ever, ever. But today, because of your birthday, and because you almost became our bozo, I have one of my original noses, and you're the only one in the world that has one autographed by me. You can read what I said right on there if you want, and it's yours.
Well, first, let me shake your hand. Thank you very much.
It's my pleasure.
It says 5595 to my pal Brian, Larry Bozo.
It's a pleasure. And with that, I think it would be nice. When I was an agent, way back in the 40s, I helped discover Nat King Cole. And
is he here?
Sort of.
Happy birthday, buddy.
In spirit?
In spirit,
yes.
Because I had a birthday. I said, why does everybody have the same birthday song for all these many, many years?
Right.
So I had a Bozo birthday song written, which I was then at Capitol Records, which I did not record. Nat was going to do it, and he never did it, so it never got recorded. But I'd like to present it on the behalf of Nat King Cole myself to you today with A Very Bozo Birthday, A Very Bozo Birthday, for every candle on your cake, Brian, A Very Bozo Birthday.
Yeah. He tried to hug with the hair.
Boy, that was sorry, did I get you? Sorry.
No, I was hoping you would.
I know, while you guys were talking, you both were on Channel 5 for a quick second, and then they're going to come back for more. Larry, thank you for coming in, sir.
Thank you very much.
It's an honor to have you.
A very, very happy birthday to you. May you have
thank
many
you,
more. May you both reach the 50 years that I've been lucky enough to do, too.
Thank you, Larry. We'll do our best, and thanks for making me grow up good.
Well, I've never left the show, ever. In my whole life, all over the world, without saying what your old pal Bozo always says.
Say
and just remember what your old pal Bozo always says. Just keep laughing.
Yeah!
See you all around like a donut.
Thanks, Bozo.
Bye-bye.
Supposed to be like play Brian's favorite tune.
I thought this was your favorite.
It was not. I don't want to be branded.
You know, frankly, there was a time when you showed us the hustle.
As a bet.
Well, the fact of the matter is, the idea of seeing Bozo the Clown do the hustle is almost too. He's stepping back.
All right.
He's about to do it, y'all. Bozo the Clown is going to do the hustle for us. Work it, baby.
the hair. That is a spoiler on a car, that hair right there.
It's the nappy dugout.
Speaking of the nappy dugout, it has become... Here, hang on. Get you one more little Cinco de... Happy Cinco de Mayo, brother.
Dude, this tequila thing.
Happy Cinco de Mayo.
This is not a good idea. We do this one time a year, and I just don't think
it's your damn birthday.
I don't.
It's Cinco de Mayo.
Okay, cameras off.
There's cameras
all cameras
off. Away.
The institution will not see Bozo, you know.
Point it up. There you go.
Okay, institution won't see it.
Exactly.
You don't want to see...
And you know what? It's good you're doing that.
Bozo kicking back and having a few shots.
Now give me a bell. Yeah, see, this is your birthday, and it's Cinco de Mayo, so celebrate and enjoy. Plus, it makes them old bits easier to go down. All right, he's taking the shot. He's going to get him by the limit. Now, on the program, you have confessed on numerous occasions what a huge, huge fan of cheese that you are. So we asked the two lovely young ladies.
Oh, they were in a limo this morning.
Yes, they were.
These ladies.
We have for you from the Wisconsin Cheese Dairy, which, by the way, is cheese country. They have
sure
for you
is.
a sampling of Wisconsin cheeses.
Honestly, do you see this? Now, this is cheese.
That is cheese.
This ain't no, like, brie.
Right.
This is cheese. You got your cheddar, you got your longhorn, you got your Swiss. You got your cheddar, Monterey kind of Jack Nick.
Right.
You got cheese.
And we also have the, now the ladies have...
Cameras off, again. Bozo will.
The ladies
if
have...
I'm to eat cheese out of a breast, I have some cleavage. I want this on tape.
The ladies have poignantly placed various cheeses around their body. And Bozo, five shots to the wind, will now eat cheese off this lady's chest.
He's got a problem on that nose.
I do.
Well, just move it down under your chin.
And I just realized that I, as Brian, underneath all the Bozo makeup, just gave a real perv look. And you don't want that. Here's what it was with the makeup. You just don't want that.
You can't have that going on. So Bozo is now leaning forward to grab him some cheese. Having him some cheese. Now, there's various cheeses you can sample throughout the day.
You know?
So, these
over
ladies.
The years, we've had strippers.
Yes, we have.
We've had beautiful women in here.
Yes, we have.
From all walks of life, actually.
Yes.
Never did I think I'd be sitting here in a clown outfit. I'm enjoying
this. Hey, geez, I'm
there's like, something... Let me try to give you an inside look at this. There's something very, very kinky about this. this is kinky.
You're enjoying it a little too much, baby. Mm-hmm. All right, so anyway, here's your Wisconsin passport that takes you to the Wisconsin dairy products
cheese
thing. So if you're ever in the, screw it.
Hey, so, you're in old Wisconsin. Make sure you stop by and get some tea.
Yeah, you know, hell with them.
All right.
All right, so.
Hell with them.
Now, these two ladies here, by the way, they do perform on a daily basis at Bob's Classy Ladies. That phone number down there is 818-787-2627. Wait a minute, did we pay these ladies? We paid them cash? Well, then, go find them for yourself. You know, they're down there at Bob's Classy Lady doing shows, so check them out. They put on a good show each and every day at Bob's Classy Ladies. All right, now, so we don't get behind, let's go back now yet another 10 years as we find various bits we perform together. Mark and Brian's... Lie detector.
Oh. Are lying to you? Impossible, you say? Yes, until now. Cavalcade Products presents the Mark and Brian Lie Detector Wristwatch. The secret is this built-in gentle warning device that alerts you to any lie. Just imagine the many ways you wives can use the Mark and Brian Lie Detector Wristwatch.
Oh, Melvin.
Yes, dear.
How do you like my new watch?
Oh, that's real nice.
Tell me, Melvin. Have you ever cheated on me?
Oh, no. Well, there was this one time. Okay, twice, but I was drinking at the time. All right, there's this Chinese volleyball team, see?
And
what
was it?
And
husbands, the Mark and Brian Lie Detector Wristwatch can literally pay for itself when used on the wife.
Hey, Bernice?
Yes, dear?
Could I borrow that watch from you?
This watch, dear?
Yes, darling.
Well, all right.
Thank you. Where you been?
Nowhere. I was shopping.
Ah. Did you spend any money?
No, but I bought a jacket. Well, it was a mink jacket, but that's all. Well, it was another small thing. Okay, it was a large thing. Okay, it was a car. I bought a car.
I bought a car.
Yes, you'll have hours of fun with the Mark and Brian Lie Detector. detector wristwatch.
Now, as far as your sex life goes, do you consider yourself to be kinky?
Oh, no. Well, I've done it outside once. Well, it was in a football stadium. All right, the game was going on. I had this leather harness on, okay? Look, I don't know how the Wild Boar got in there. All right, the nuns volunteered, okay? Wild Boar.
Yes, the Mark and Brian lie detector wristwatch. It really does make a great Christmas gift.
Are you remembering these at all?
I am. I remember when we did them. I remember when we thought about doing them. I just keep wanting to scream out the word, David! But other than that, it was years back. Years like, what, 10, 9, 19 years ago?
I gotta tell you something.
Amazing. It's fun to hear these again. I hadn't heard them in years.
It's kind of cool for me in that we did these. I had a studio in my home that I built and put together in the house. And it's still set up, even though we don't use it anymore, it's still set up out in the drum room. So every day that I go in there, there it is. And that little area right over on the thing where we had the special mic and that...
Like a monument.
Well, do you remember there was a hole cut in the console where you could move your chair up in? You had your own headphone stuff. And I look at it every day. Every single day. And it's cool to see.
Let's bronze it! The whole thing.
All right, see if you remember this.
Don't wanna.
Blast from the past.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the playoffs, the championships, if you will, of Make That Tune. We have our two contestants, and of course, to see which, in fact, is the most well-versed in the music world of today. Okay, contestants, are you ready?
All set, Bob.
Let's go to the first tune then. The first tune is a Lithuanian chant that was believed to be written somewhere around 12 A.D. It was just recently discovered along with the remains of an ancient Asian princess. It has never been released to the public, and only a few chosen archaeologists have heard it. So, name that tune.
Bob, I'd like to start the bidding here by saying I can name that tune in three notes, Bob.
Well, I think I can safely say I can name it in two notes.
Oh, well, okay. Yeah, I can name that tune in one note, Bob.
Well, then I think you might need to name that tune, young Bob.
Well, there you heard it. One note. Let's name that tune.
Yeah, that may be Overstrava Frugal Farm Concerto in E-flat, Bob.
That's exactly right, Bob.
Thank you.
Well, let's take it on down to the big championship. By the way, good job there, big fella.
Thanks, Bob. Thank you very much. When it comes to Overstrava Frugal Farms, Concerto in E-flat,
Thank you very much. Appreciate you coming on out. Well, the second song and the championship, might I add, would have to be a tune written during the Revolutionary War by a man named Francis Scott Key. He gazed over the side of a ship, awestruck at the magnitude of a great battle taking place. The song was later adopted as our country's national anthem and is to this day performed before all sporting events. Can you name that tune?
Well, Bob, I'm pretty confident I can name this tune in 16 notes, Bob. 16 notes ought to do it.
And I think I can name that tune in 15 notes. I think I can. I feel strong. I think I can. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bob, you know me. I'm always one to look for competition. I think, maybe going on a limb here a little bit, but I think I can name that tune in 14 notes, Bob.
Well, then just name that tune.
Okay, there you have it. 14 notes. National anthem, the Star Spangled Banner.
You're kidding.
That's what it was.
You're kidding.
Ladies and gentlemen, we simply do not have a winner.
I've never heard that song before.
It's a dead draw, and that means we get to keep all the prizes.
I like the tune, no, it's a
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been another hot competition here. I give you a chance to join us back again sometime, and don't forget, don't be a prune. Come on, name that tune.
What's that? Don't be a prune.
Name that tune.
Hey now.
How about rating?
Once again, how about that rating, baby? Yeah. All right, as we look at the clock on the wall, we do have time to fit in just one more.
Well, wait a minute. When was that?
That was the first month we were on the air.
Wow.
Yeah, this is, again, we had known each other for maybe 15 days.
I actually wasn't any part of that, so that was a stunt, Brian. That was actually...
Oh, well, you were part of this one. Going back again another 10 years, let's enjoy Square Dancers.
I was walking onto the dance floor with a girl, and I saw them. I've seen some strange things, but never anything like this. Thousands of oddly matched colors that denied all rules of good taste, so bright they were blinding. The stench of pure polyester filled the room. Then they began oozing onto the dance floor.
Just when you thought it was safe to go back on the dance floor, Square Dancers. They dance in great numbers, conquering the floor wherever they go.
Jimmy, get off the dance floor! Get off! Brian, you're
stuck! They're here! Square Dancers. Bright patent leather shoes, men wearing silk scarves, petticoats. Square Dancers. When terror cuts a rug.
I love that. When terror cuts a rug. Hey, baby!
Yeah, I remember that.
All right, if you just joined us, it is Brian's 36th birthday. We're also throwing in some Cinco de Mayo, and we also celebrate our 10th anniversary together. Of
yeah, throwing program. In that big chunk of Cinco. Throwing in a chunk of Cinco tomorrow, right?
Bozo the Clown's over here, 5 shots of the wind, about to be 6, too.
Yeah.
All right,
tell you what, this makeup, the costume, doesn't matter. You know, it's pretty comfortable.
Good.
It's the nose. It's this red plastic nose. It's cutting into me. It is.
Well, now, you're going to be on Channel 5 probably in the next 15 minutes. He said 8:50.
Can't wait. Oh, God.
He said 8:50 was going to be when they break in. So if you're at the house or if you're about to leave, roll a videotape. Brian as Bozo the Clown is going to be on Channel 5 at 10 minutes till 9. So stand by for that. We'll do some commercials in return. It's Brian's 36th birthday. And we're back right after this.
Thompson has a family to feed, and she's just...
Wow, I was going to take off my headphones. It's his hair.
Brian, you are the monkey man, grand and standing with your grinder. Your birthday bash is in full swing now. Tiny critters hang from your hair. screaming Brian's name now, celebrating your great 10 years. So may God bless you on this 36th year and fill you with his Holy Spirit.
Oh, that was great, Justin! Oh, that was fabulous! Once again, we'll see you back in just a few minutes.
Happy birthday.
Okay, down at the hootie hole there, and Justine was able to come by. That's fabulous. Bozo.
Huh? What? What?
Pull your hair down some. It's starting to creep.
Down?
Yeah, just too much. Way too much.
Way too much.
Back up a little bit. Okay, good. But
Justine Bateman is here. Just so you know.
All right, Justine, first of all, thank you for coming in. That was very nice of you. And might I add, you fit into the hootie hole so absolutely perfectly. You do read poetry at coffee houses around town, do you not?
Well, I have done that in the past. It's true.
You write that stuff and you bring it in, and you wrote that piece today.
I did, just right on the spot, just for Brian.
Thank you.
Can I have that? Where is that?
Yes, you can.
Okay, that's... will you sign it and stuff?
Uh-huh.
Justine Bateman's here.
All right, now, Justine...
Oh, and you know, this is pretty weird.
And you just like Buzz.
Trying to make a good impression, right? Want to put my best 16-inch foot forward. And, you know, I go to hug her to say thanks just now, and I almost put her eye out with the hair.
Oh, that's too good. All right, now flip it over to Channel 5. How long before you guys are on the air with it?
Who knows?
Okay, so it's
great planning today.
30 seconds.
Now, Justine, I hope that you can hang with us at least for the next hour. Because we not only have a lot of stuff we want to talk with you about that you've got going on, but there's also something that you might want to be involved in, something very special that's coming up.
I don't think I can make it to Brian's little pool party.
Yes, you
is
can.
That, I
no,
don't
no,
think
it's not a pool party,
up.
Trust me.
Okay,
we don't even have to leave the grounds.
Okay.
What is she talking about?
I don't know.
Whatever you've got happening over
there. I have nothing happening. I
dress like that, I don't doubt
what
it.
What is, do you have something? Did you plan something that...
Not after 10, no.
Okay.
No, I mean, this is what it is. It's the birthday show.
Okay.
All right, now, if you just joined us, this is Brian's 36th birthday. Yes. Justine Bateman has just joined him. She was, first of all, a fabulous, wonderful, and you must return guest to the Hootie Hole.
Justine.
And Brian's here dressed as Bozo the Clown. We also celebrate
Dig Me.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Loving you, big fella. All right, again, if you're at the house or at work and you have a television.
I can't get close to her.
Flip it over to KTLA Channel 5. Justine,
for a
moment, why don't you talk about some of the items that you have going on in your life. There's something very important that you're involved in.
Yeah, there's something that is so fantastic that's going on right now. The Holy Spirit is pouring out in a really powerful way all over the world. And one of the places is in Pasadena. Mm. And it is happening at Mott Auditorium in Pasadena every Tuesday through Sunday night at 7. And that's at 1555 East Howard Street. And it's sponsored by area wide churches. And people can call 818-398-2488 for more information. But it's like, it's just such incredible, incredible stuff happening.
Cool. And you'll be there.
Yes.
And God has blessed me. I can be on the ministry team, and it's just a fantastic thing. And I just invite everyone to just come and check out what God has for them.
Excellent. Thank you very much. All right, now, how long?
A minute.
Because we're supposed to take a break.
Well, don't take a break.
All right, we'll stay here. Well, we could take a break, and we'll just be on channel. No? All right, we'll keep it here. We'll stay right here.
Hey, have you seen Justine's movie on, it's just finally came to pay movie channel? Uh-huh. What's it called? The one you're a rocker. Here, I can do you. I do you in this. I do you in this.
Bozo standing up.
God, I feel like I'm looking in a mirror.
See? The one where you're the band.
Satisfaction.
Satisfaction.
That's the name of the movie?
Uh-huh.
Satisfaction.
She's a lead singer of an all-girl, almost all-girl rock band.
Yeah.
It's very, very good. She's very good.
Is that HBO or Showtime?
Hey, we're at KLOS Radio. Okay, Mark and Brian, 10 years together, and it's Brian's 36th birthday. He always wanted to be Bozo. So today, he dressed up as Bozo.
We need to clarify something. Hi, everyone. You've been listening? This is Justine Bateman. No, this is
Bateman right here. This is Justine celebrating the birthday as well.
Hello.
You're a very effective Bozo. In fact, I'd have to say you are a real Bozo.
Thank you very much. Tell him why this is, because now people are going to think something.
Very quickly, Brian auditioned for the part of the WGN in Chicago Bozo.
My sister station, that's right.
He didn't get the part, but it came down to him and one other guy. He was that close. And so today,
many years ago,
he was transformed by the official Bozo makeup guy.
Surprise.
And the first ever Bozo came in to congratulate him and give him an autographed nose.
Yes. This is one of those gags that didn't work all that well on radio. We needed television as well. But let me tell you, you are a very...
You know what they say. You know what they say.
What the rumor is.
Huh?
You've been dancing around. You want to show us a little bit of your dance? You were doing the hustle here earlier.
No.
And actually, you were driving around. You were driving around town showing up.
They took us to Carl's Jr.'s, and I entertained a child.
Were people shocked when they saw you? Did they think it was the real Bozo?
Yeah, they were shocked. In fact, many of them went like this.
All right, so what is it next year? Perhaps Daffy Duck, Mickey Mouse, something like that?
I don't know, you cute man. You get it. He's a good man, isn't he?
I have my own Bozo nose.
Do you? Oh, congrats. See, actually, everyone wants to be a clown.
Everybody does want to be Bozo. Hey, a lot of famous people were Bozos. Did you know that Willard Scott
was
a Bozo? And Johnny Mountain, Channel 7
weatherman.
That's
right. That's right. Bozo. Yes, and Keanu Reeves.
Keanu Reeves.
For many, many years, about 17 years he was a Bozo.
I didn't know that.
Before he got into like the major motion picture thing. So, yeah.
All right, well, congratulations.
Dolph Lundgren, Brad Pitt.
Okay, see, now he's joking. I bought the Keanu Reeves thing. I bought it.
Not for 17 years.
Jeez, I mean, think of it. God, what an idiot.
36 years old, and you've been together for 10 years. Are you guys getting sick of each other yet?
Yeah. No.
Really?
No, we're not.
No, I mean, the syndication of the program has really kind of brought a fresh new feel in it for us.
And the fact that we're so, you know, even in when we're together. We actually don't try to hog any of the camera.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brian Bozo, if you would.
Shut
check
up!
It out. All feel right. It.
Happy birthday, Brian. Happy anniversary to both of you guys.
Justine Bateman.
And we'll see you around Christmas time. I know you guys always come around.
You bet we do, and we will again.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Congratulations to you. Bye-bye.
I love you.
Right on.
No, he looks the same to me.
All right. Yeah. We will take a commercial break just as they have. So stay
they bought the Bozo thing.
Brian's 36th birthday celebration on the Mark and Brian program.
We're clear, Mikey? No, are we on the air, though?
Okay, you want to play?
This is the one. What? About a year and a half ago.
Conference room, come on in. Here we are.
There's a piano, there's a grand piano.
Oh, this is special. This is really special. Brian, have a chair. Right here at the special reserve. Welcome, Brian, to the Hootie.
The Hootie Hall!
Cheeses arranged on this tray.
Wonderful.
I've got to be honest, we knew earlier this morning when we were on the air that you were coming later today. We have a very special treat. We don't normally, as you know, here at the Hootie Hole, allow musical accompaniments. Normally, it's just set aside for various talents of people that enjoy the Hootie Hole. But today, because of your special birthday, we do have a very special musical guest. We know that one of your favorite things musically is jazz. You're a lover of jazz.
I love jazz.
We have a gentleman here that has, he's covered an array of musical talents for years, done many different kinds of music, and he's moved himself into the jazz area. Everybody at the Hootie Hole, especially for you, Brian, please put it together and welcome the talents of Mr. Gino Vannelli. Let's have it. Gino.
Oh, by the way, Gino, this is Justine Bateman. Justine Bateman, Gino.
Hi.
Salute.
Here we have from the Tonight Show band on horn, Mr. Yes. Chuck Finley.
Yeah, Chuck. Yes,
Chuck. Accompanying Gino on piano, we have Mr. Randy Porter.
Randy!
And a big Hootie Hole welcome to the stand-up bass cat, Mr. Phil. Especially for you, never before performed at the Hootie Hole, and for the rest of you, please welcome Gino Vannelli.
Yeah! All right, Gino! Yeah.
All right, let's go,
yeah.
outside your door. You're
thought of you as being too hip for the room, and I just want you to know that you will never be
too hip
for this room. This room. That was great. That was a gift.
And Chuck, gotta tell you, baby, you were nasty bad on the horn, baby. Blow that thing for us here. All right.
I also like Chuck's eyes when it's like, do we end this now or what?
All right, now, Gino, last night in the back room, I had a chance to sample some of the new CD, The Yonder Tree. And you're going to have to do...
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I had a chance to sample it back in the back room.
How are you?
I'm doing good, man. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Gino, you're going to have to do a little bit of Judas. That's a great tune.
Yeah!
Yeah, all right.
Okay, yeah, Judas!
I
don't
need anybody's help. I'm about to bring you your fingers in.
Pitch in. Everybody.
Wait for the count. Happy birthday. All right, well, let's do that. This is my iconoclastic song. Everybody know what that means?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
It's some sort of a material that you use.
Iconoclastic. All right. How about here, guys?
Ding day.
Ding day.
Your collar is short. There's a woman in Jesus.
You've enjoyed fully.
Very much.
Okay, now, Gino, Gino, we know that these tunes you played are from your new CD, The Yonder Tree, which is soon to be out. We've seen the artwork. It's close. And what's the date on it?
23rd.
Okay. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, can we taste a bit of the past when we move back in here?
Yes.
There you go. We'll do that, play a few commercials, and come back to the Mark and Brian program.
I love that one.
Gino Vannelli on Brian's 36th birthday. We're back after this.
How about in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah! Okay, Brian's on his way back in here. He took the suit off and he couldn't find his pants. He's trying to locate his drawers now. We'll take a minute then, Gino, and we'll talk about the fact that you have done, one of the cool things about your music career is you've always done exactly as you wanted to do. You did and put on disc what you pleased. And this is a whole new, you found it?
On my pants.
You've always done precisely what you felt and you heard in your own head, and this CD that's coming out, The Yonder Tree, is an example of that. You've done a really classy, jazzy kind of approach to a very simplistic piece of music, and it sounds really good on you.
Well, thank you. You know, it's always been one of my fortunes to be able to do what I hear inside and put it on CD. I've been fortunate since 1972 to make this kind of album.
That's why we like you at our Christmas show, because we like people to see what you look like when it's coming out of you.
Oh, it's huge. Huger than huge. It's big, big.
You'll like it. Way big. Yeah.
But there's a pay big.
We got your pay, and it's hanging here with us, Gino.
Does the word goose egg mean anything?
All right. For those of you listening in the other cities and those of you in the room, there's a few listeners that were brought in this morning for this. This is something that he's going to do that may remind you of some moments in the past. So music of today and yesterday. Gino Vannelli, once again, everybody. Yes!
Something I wrote then.
Yeah.
yourself sure.
Don't worry, boy,
Thank you.
So, Gino, how much did you get paid?
Oh, my God.
Speak towards Gino. Between two speak.
Hey, wait a minute. Have it come down just a little bit.
Now, is this one of those cake things?
Just lay down. This way.
And you know, with the clown,
what is
all he
had is.
What's that?
This near your stomach, right?
This near.
Yeah, keep going. Have you noticed that without the suit and the hair, this clown makeup, I look like a headhunter? Watch it.
Ungawa.
I told you it worked.
All right, here we go then.
You know, if this doesn't inspire you to write a cool song,
groovy.
Groovy. Okay, we have for you now. Are you ready, Gary?
Is this going to give you...
Hey, is this Feed the Kitty?
Are you ready? This
is the dream of every Laker fan who's ever been to a game.
Rita? Oh, man.
special. Cool. It's a really good-looking cake.
It's a Bozo cake.
Happy 10th and 36th. Bozo's on it, the Mark and Brian logo, and, of course, at the top,
eat me.
Eat.
Okay, then. That's a gorgeous cake.
All right, listen, bud. Happy birthday.
Thanks, Mark.
Happy anniversary.
Love you.
Love you, too. All right. Now, if you want to, that Patron tequila is still in the control room.
I need to ask you, what was the point of the Patron tequila?
It makes the birthday
Patron
show.
Tequila.
It makes the birthday show even better.
It was, but you didn't. Let's go.
All right, listen. We will be back on Monday morning, kicking off bright and early, 6 o'clock. We invite you to be with us. Otherwise, have yourself a grand weekend.
Be good humans, everybody. Thanks a lot.
See you next week, guys.